hockey night in Pittsburgh. Tonight, from the PPG Paints Arena in downtown Pittsburgh, PA, the National Hockey League presents the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Dallas Stars. Here's Crosby trying to get something going. He crosses that blue line into the Dallas zone. Leaves the right side of the tie, and he hammers a heavy shot. That missed. He ends up back on the far side. Crosby's got it near side. Gensel shot. It's in. Gensel put it in. I don't know if it hit something on the way in or not, but it caught Hudobin, hops in, and Jake Gensel, set up beautifully by Crosby, gives the Penguins the first goal. Oh, no. Eddie Spaghetti. It's Gensel.
It's Gensel with the one-timer, and he hammered it, Mikey. It had so much steam on it. It broke right through the body of Anton Hudobin. But what a pass by Sidney Crosby. On the backhand, while in full flight in the offensive zone, it's a thing of beauty. It has the perfect tempo. It is flat, and it is right inside the back foot, right where you want it for the one-timer. And Jake just hammers it, and it wiggles around between the legs of Hudobin into the back of the net. Penguins lead 1-0.
The left side to Kessel. Comes halfway down the boards. Leaves the puck for Evgeny Malkin. Back to Crystal Tang and the fans. On to Malkin's stick. Moves into the high slot. Dragging the puck. Waiting. Shooting. Scoring! It is Evgeny Malkin from the right wing circle side. Just snapping that puck by Hudobin, and the Penguins have a 2-0 lead. Just one look. That's all it took.
Oh, Mikey, you painted it perfect. Waiting, waiting, waiting. The patience of Evgeny Malkin. What's he doing on that side of the ice? There was some unpredictability from the Penguins' power play here with Malkin on the left side of the ice. He's always posting up on the right side for the one-timer, but he goes over to support Chris Letang, and a little give-and-go between Malkin and Letang, and there's Patrick Hornquist again. In the high slot, just as the shot's coming from Malkin, he jumps up in the air to let the puck go underneath his feet, just over the right pad of Hudobin, underneath the blocker. Perfectly placed shot by Evgeny Malkin to give the Penguins a 2-0 lead.
Probably known more for the big trade between St. Louis and Montreal. There's a one-for-one with Guy Carboneau.
Here comes Crosby on the rush, back with an end, and he gets it loose from Hudobin and pokes it in. He got the shot away. Hudobin stopped it then, just for a quick half second. It was loose. Crosby got the stick back out and knocks it home. Penguins lead 3-0. Oh, Michael motorcycle. The quick hands of Sir Sidney.
You got it all there, Mikey. You got the speed, the strength, the skill, all of it off the charts for Sidney Crosby. And what I loved about this goal was the puck support by the Penguins, the way they systematically came out of their zone and got it up to Sidney Crosby. And then Sid, with that strength on the backhand, he opens up his feet against the defenseman, Esa Lindell. Mikey, one is at 9 o'clock, the other one is at 3 o'clock. That gives him leverage while he's able to stay at Mach 1 coming down the right wing. His initial backhand was stopped by the goaltender, Hudobin, but he stayed with it, and he got himself his own rebound and chips it in. 3-0 Penguins.
Towards the net, off the right pad of Hudobin. Picked up here by Dumoulin on the rebound, way out. Steers it in behind the net. Polak gets it around to Esa Lindell on the defenseman, pops it up in the air, it goes behind the defense, goes over to Sagan, walks in under Smith, and he stops him cold on a breakaway chance. That was a strange play. Was it Dumoulin who fell down?
It was. Yeah. It was a lob pass, and Dumoulin did not anticipate the lob very well, and all of a sudden he was on his face.
Yeah.
As he tried to block it, he knew that Sagan was in behind him, so he went after that puck, and all of a sudden it came to the ice, and it bounced right past Brian Dumoulin. And Sagan anticipated that puck perfectly and all by himself and sold his best move to Casey DeSmith. And DeSmith was all over with that blocker.
Hornquist pop it over far side. Crosby looks for Hornquist in front of the cage. Can't get it to him, but Crosby finds it again. He's wheeling and dealing, going left side to Ole Matta. Shoots the puck, save made. Rebound, Hornquist. He shoots and scores. Patrick Hornquist on the rebound play. Penguins make it 4-0. And Hudobin doesn't know whether to cry or wind his watch. Crosby magnificent tonight. Absolutely magnificent.
That's it, Mikey. That play never happens if it's not for the skill and the will of Sidney Crosby to corral that turnover by the Dallas Stars
and then hit the brakes and find Olli Määttä coming in from the left point. Just a beautiful pinpoint tape-to-tape pass from Crosby to Määttä, and nice shot selection by Olli to wrist it at the cage with Hornquist in front. He gets separation from the defenseman, Joel Hanley, and there's no chance for Hudobin on Patrick Hornquist, who shovels it past the blocker.
On the mark, Jan Marco's left side, and now it comes over, and here's a quick shot right to the goal and stopped by Chris Smith. Left side, Hanley, the defenseman, goes down deep in the corner. He tried to center, it comes right back to him. Go to Pollock now, a shot by Como. That stopped, the rebound, quick save there on the rebound on the Dallas Stars as Jan Marco had an opportunity. Casey to Smith with two big saves here in this second period. Down to the right wing of the Penguins zone. Off the stick of Derek Grant. That put this shuffle to the Dallas line. Comes over to Tanner Pearson. Shoots and he scores. Yes, he did. He got it in and out with a booming heavy slapper. And the Penguins take a 5-0 lead. Oh, shave my face with a rusty razor. That's the Tanner Pearson we've seen before.
What a bomb. What a bomb by Tanner Pearson. And partner, let's give Derek Grant a lot of credit. He was at the end of a shift. He hunted down this puck. He forced a turnover and then had the awareness of not slow roll it to the bench for a change. He looked over his shoulder and said, oh man, my teammate might get to a loose puck here. Tanner Pearson, let me make sure I'm onside. He sprinted to the blue line, straddled the blue line. Tanner Pearson comes down the left wing, gets his head up. He rips it. He lets it fly short side under the bar, and it's 5-0 Penguins, and we have a goaltending change.
Well, the Stars will bring on Landon Boe. He'll get an opportunity to play. And Boe just up from Texas with the injury to Ben Bishop. And he's going to be in that net. Hard work here by both teams on the boards. Jam back into the near corner, Pittsburgh zone. And Radek Faksa. Faksa sets up Pitlick. Wrist shot. Good save there by Casey DeSmith. Keeps it 5-0. A pull back towards the Penguins in. The time played right off one of the Stars. Right there, off. On the right wing, put it in front. Hintz with a backhander, and he scores. It's 5-1. Rube Hintz on the backhand shot from in front. Radulov held the puck on the far boards, put it in front, and Hintz spotted it and nails it, and it's 5-1.
Self-inflicted pain. It's not fair to Casey DeSmith what happened here, Mikey. Chris Letang goes back for a puck, and he turns and just wildly, I call it a hoper play, because you're not sending the puck up the ice with a purpose, being smart through the middle of the ice. Chris Letang turns the puck over, Radulov strong to the puck, and a spinorama backhand pass by Radulov finds Rupe Hintz all by himself as the puck goes right between the legs of Chris Letang to Hintz, and then with traffic in front of Casey DeSmith, Hintz goes forehand, backhand, shelf. No chance for Casey DeSmith. It's 5-1.
Allison battling for the puck. Dickinson over there. 7 seconds left. Como's in trying to get a piece of it. Time is going to run out. And that's it. Tonight, the Penguins at home against the Dallas Stars break a four-game losing streak as they defeat Dallas, the final, Pittsburgh 5, and the Stars 1.